The following video presentation is brought to you by the UVM Alumni Association.
In Burlington, Vermont, the Seawolves of Stony Brook can clinch the conference title today. They had their game faces on when they arrived this morning. Vermont is looking for a big game from Luke Apfel. He had 18 against Stony Brook in Stony Brook and Vermont on CBS Sports Network. Welcome to Patrick Gymnasium at the University of Vermont, sold out for this important meeting between Stony Brook and the Vermont Catamounts. A short time ago, Vermont's head coach, John Becker, addressed his team in the Catamounts locker room about this important matchup.
Look, you guys, another great opportunity for us. All right, another great opportunity for us. All right, and this is why you come to University of Vermont. This is why you come here. All right, play meaningful games in February. All right, meaningful games in February. All right, so all the hard work you guys have put in the offseason, all the hard work you put in this season, you know, gives you an opportunity like today. All right, nationally televised game, sellout crowd, 3,200 people out there. All right, so they've beaten us the last two times we played. Last year they ended our season. All right, and that taste really hasn't got out of my mouth and in our mouth.
There's Carissimo. He's been scoring. Apfel, who had a huge game, starts off fast again. He had a huge game at Stony Brook today and wins out. They both finished 14-2. Vermont has the tiebreaker. They've beaten the number three team, Austin Hughes, twice this season. Keep counting them. Here is Apfel shooting, and he's up and down with two tries. Ball was tipped. It was not over and back. Pulling up and hitting the shot. Is Sandro Carissimo. Career 320s, over 1,500 points as a scorer. Great long ball look. Matt Glass missed a practice.
No, and that jump shot is setting up his drive.
Just trying to get it to McGlynn, who's in the game for McGlynn. Down low. New guys think is the most important guy to winning games with all the things he does, but that time he's intercepted, and here is Four McGlynn, the freshman. What a great look. He was bumped hard, got it up and down. And Stony Brook needs a timeout. Goal after building a 12-point lead. The lead to one. For McGlynn. They get a roll and a big ovation from sold-out Patrick Gymnasium.
First team to 50. They may have to struggle to get to 50.
Well, we've had no points in the second half. It's as it was at the half. And there is a driving shot. Going hard to the basket is Sandro Carissimo. The backup guards combined to score 31 points in Stony Brook's last game. Banging the big one is Matt Glass. Sets up a shooter. Shooter hits. Joe Elbaum with a big assist and the big three.
Yeah, Coley did he got lost that time.
If they win it, here.
I don't see, you've got to stay with him, Don. He's been too open.
Carissimo gets it out. Glass, he's an open shot. Blocking foul, score the basket. No charge. And Vermont, all of a sudden, has opened up its biggest advantage of the game. A 14-point lead. 15-point lead. McGlynn.
Stewart just shaking his head. I mean, he was right in front of him. Didn't have a hand up, but
looking for a shooter. He finds one.
They're just putting too much pressure on him from the three-point line. And Stony Brook players just looking around at each other with their hands down.
Back, skip pass back over the top. There is a Four McGlynn.
Why, how many times has McGlynn gotten open in that corner?
Maybe far too late. Open shooter.
Boy,
18-point lead. 68-49 win as Vermont blows it open in the second half. Jason Knapp and Tammy Blackburn are standing by at Moody Coliseum. I'm going to send you now to Moody Coliseum for women's basketball between Southern Miss and SMU. Thanks for joining us.